Now, the Philippine Supreme Court nullifies the contempt and arrest order of a Senate committee.
Senate Durban Committee against formerly Executive Lincoln Ong and former Duterte Administration Presidential Economic Advisor Michael Yang. In 2021, the two were cited in contempt by the Blue Ribbon Committee, then headed by former Senator Richard Gordon, over their supposed refusal to answer questions during the probe into alleged anomalies in the procurement of COVID-19 medical supplies. It was estimated that formally, a company with supposed links to Yang bagged 11 billion pesos in government contracts for the procurement of test kits and face masks at the height of the pandemic. Yang and Ong challenged the Senate orders before the Supreme Court, also questioning the constitutionality of Section 18 of the Senate Rules on Inquiries, which allows the Senate to hold in contempt a witness who testifies falsely or evasively. In nullifying the contempt orders, the Supreme Court en banc said that while the Senate has the power to conduct inquiries in aid of legislation and the accompanying powers to declare a witness in contempt and order his or her arrest, the Senate panel failed to accord petitioners their rights relative to the conduct of its proceedings. The High Court said the contempt orders finding that Ong and Yang testified falsely and evasively lacks factual basis. The Supreme Court said in the decision that Ong was able to subsequently assert that they had other funds sourced from the savings of their incorporators. The High Court said the Senate panel committed grave abuse of discretion when it cited Ong and Yang in contempt and ordered their arrests without giving them the opportunity to be heard. But the High Court also said the phrase testifies falsely or evasively in Section 18 of the Senate Rules on Inquiries is not vague and can be understood by persons of common knowledge or intelligence, declining to declare it unconstitutional. It also upheld the Senate Committee's request for the Department of Justice to issue a lookout bulletin against Yang and its authority to compel Yang to answer questions and submit documents regarding his property and business interests, including information about himself. In a statement, formerly lawyer Ferdinand Topacio says the decision affirmed their constant cry that the Senate was converted into a kangaroo court. Topacio also said the decision is a great step toward curbing the abuses against resource persons during Senate investigations. Senator Risa Ontiveros, however, stressed that Yang and Ong were not absolved by the Supreme Court, noting that the ombudsman had recommended the filing of criminal complaints against Ong and other former Duterte administration officials. Adrian Ayalin, ABS-CBN News.
The leader of the lower chamber looking forward to better relations with the Dutertes. House Speaker Martin Romualdez made that remark after Vice President Sara Duterte dropped her bid for confidential funds. This earned the approval of Romualdez, saying the Vice President made the right decision. Tensions between the lower chamber and the Dutertes started after lawmakers stripped the secret funds of the Vice President's offices, which sparked harsh criticisms of the chamber by former President Rodrigo Duterte. Despite the brewing friction, Romualdez debunks an alleged rift in the unity.
Still a unity. The president always wants us to work together, not just in Congress, with the executive, but as a country. So we will always strive for that. As they always say, there will always be differences, but we will always work towards resolving those differences.
Former Senator Laila de Lima granted temporary freedom after more than 6 years in detention. As Jeff Caparaz tells us, the staunch critic of the Duterte administration's drug war was allowed to post bail by the court handling her third and last drug case.
After more than 6 years, former Senator Laila de Lima finally heard the words she had been praying for. Declared by the court on Monday, bail granted. De Lima burst into tears and hugged her supporters.
Sinabi ni Judge na in briefly sinabi niya, I granted the bail application. And hell broke loose na sa loob ng courtroom.
Sir, baka na-scared sa amin? Nagsigawan ba kayo?
Nagsigawan yung mga nasa audience. So, tsaka umiyak, tapos sumigaw si Senator Dyla na tumingin sa taas, tapos sabi niya, freedom finally.
Outside the court, Supporters rejoice upon hearing the court's decision. The court ordered a 300,000 bail peso each for De Lima, former Bureau of Corrections Director General Franklin Bucayo, Jonel Sanchez, her former aide, Ronnie Dayan, De Lima's former driver, and inmate Jose Adrian Dera.
Sa wakas, makakalaya na po ako. For years, my whole being has been crying out for justice and freedom. For more than 6 long years, I've been praying so hard for this day to come. At alam niyo po, napakasakit. Ang
aslang, baka masubsob kayo.
Na wala kang kasalanan. At ayaw ko pong mangyari to sa iba. But I don't want to be sad or bitter today. This is a moment of triumphant joy and also of thanksgiving.
De Lima thanked God, her family, friends, her legal defense team, and Judge Jenner Guito.
Gusto ko rin pong pasalamatan ng BBM administration for respecting the independence of the judiciary and the rule of law. Sa inyo pong lahat na naniwala po sa akin, maraming salamat po.
De Lima's petition for bail was filed as early as June 2020. Since then, several witnesses have recanted their testimonies against De Lima, including Kerwin Espinosa on April 28, 2022, followed by former Bucor officer in charge Rafael Ragos. Her former driver Dayan also recanted his testimony, as well as two prosecution witnesses, Rodolfo Magleo and Nonilo Arile. On October 9, 2022, De Lima survived the hostage taking inside the PNP Custodial Center where an alleged Abu Sayyaf sub-leader, Felisano Sulayaw, attempted to escape. On February 2021, De Lima was acquitted on criminal case 167 where she was accused of receiving 70 million drug money from Bilibid. On May 2023, she was acquitted on the second drug case on conspiracy to commit illegal drug trading based on Peter Co's accusation that he gave drug money for De Lima's candidacy. The De Lima camp hopes the remaining drug case will also be dismissed this year or next year.
We've been with her since 2017, and we know how she suffered sa loob ng jail, both physically and emotionally, even to the point na muntik pa siyang mamatay. But the fight continues. Okay. Meron pang kaso Senator Laila De Lima, and this is a bail application, so hindi pa dismiss ang kaso.
Temporary
ang kanyang liberty. And we will continue to fight this case and seek its dismissal.
Vic Boy, De Lima's brother, also welcomed the decision, adding De Lima's first goal is to visit her mother in Bicol.
We're very happy. Makakauwi na ang aming kapatid, si Laila, makakabisita na sa aming nanay. The soonest time that she can go home to Bicol, she will go home.
He added, it's up to his sister to forgive those responsible for her detention. Jeff Caparaz, ABS-CBN News.
Now, former Philippine Senator Laila De Lima remains confident of the merits of her case. De Lima admits the last 6 years in detention have been a struggle, but the end of former President Rodrigo Duterte's presidency gave her hope that she would finally get a chance at freedom. The former senator also has a message for Duterte.
It is one of my greatest achievements in my career and in my life to say that not only did I survive all these years of persecution and unjust detention, I came out stronger than ever, with an even stronger commitment to truth, justice, human rights, democracy, and the rule of law. First, yung message ko kay former President Duterte, isa lang sasabihin, well, God forgive him and God bless him. He knows what he did to me, I suppose.
The international community lauds the court decision granting bail to former Senator Laila De Lima. Meanwhile, a former Senate president seeks accountability from ex-Duterte administration officials who were behind the filing of drug charges against the former senator. Details in this report.
Political allies of former Senator Laila De Lima welcomed the court's decision to allow her to post bail. Former Vice President Lenny Robredo said the allegations against De Lima are being proven baseless once again. Robredo asserted that De Lima endured abuses and pressures for almost 7 years in daring to stand up for what is right. Former Senator Franklin Drilon also believes the court's decision reflects lack of evidence on the prosecution's end. He called for accountability from the officials of the Duterte administration who are responsible for the charges against De Lima.
Somebody must answer for the having filed these charges against De Lima. Former cabinet member of the Duterte administration was supposed to have intimidated witnesses in order to testify against De Lima.
Attorney Tony Lavinia shared on social media photos of him and De Lima before and after the Monday court hearing. Lavinia is one of De Lima's legal counsel. The former spokesperson of former President Rodrigo Duterte, lawyer Harry Roque, says they respect the court's decision, even if they disagree with it. He also wonders why the court believed the witnesses who recanted their statements.
Respeto na yan, pero ako po talaga ay merong alinlangan dyan dahil ibig sabihin po niyan, pinaniniwalaan na ngayon ng hukuman ang mga papalit-palit ng version ng mga testigo. Na kapag sila'y nagsilungaling, they can get away with it.
Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla says the ruling shows the judiciary's independence. He insisted it's up to the prosecution to appeal the decision as he has no intentions to interfere with prosecution.
Respected and respect the findings of the previous prosecutors who were tasked to do this job. And it is not for me to change their judgment or their point of view with regards to this. It is for them to be able to prove their cases in court.
The international community also welcomed the bail granted to the former senator. The European Union's envoy to Manila called it a significant step for rule of law in the Philippines and expressed hope the resolution of the remaining charges will be accelerated. Canada's embassy in Manila vowed to follow the situation closely, adding it expects the charges will be concluded in full conformity with Philippine laws and obligations to international human rights. The U.S. ambassador to the Philippines also vowed to follow De Lima's case closely. The envoy says she looks forward to seeing De Lima's remaining charges resolved in accordance with Philippine law. As for Amnesty International, the court's decision is a welcome development, calling it a step towards achieving justice. Human Rights Watch Philippines believes if the Muntinlupa court acquits De Lima of her third and final drug charge, it will repair the Philippines' human rights reputation.
Obviously, the key thing to keep in mind here is the final decision by the Regional Trial Court of Muntinlupa to finally acquit her of these charges. Given the fact that there have been successive attractions of testimonies by several witnesses, there's really no reason for the court to just acquit her.